Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to talk to you about the 1940s, the golden age of country.
The 1940s was a period of revival of tango. It was a great period, a great development, great importance, and most of all, a fascination for today's dancers.
Those that lived through that period long for it with a deep nostalgia, and the young of today only wish we could unveil its mystery.
This period marks a magical time in tango. It extends all through the 50s.
In the lyrics, a sense of masculinity was exalted, compelling the men to dance and confirming their condition of being.
Juan D'Arienzo, el rey del compás, the king of the night. With his orchestra and other orchestras like the Sarli and Pugliese, brought tango out of the brothels and the back streets of Buenos Aires into the salons and the dance academies.
It was an exciting time when new moves were introduced, like the corte and the quebrada. And the repertoire of tango was extended even further.
As soon as we leave the stage, Guy and Pierre are going to perform a tango by Armando Bonfier, Milongando los Cuarentas, and choreographed beautifully by Sofia and Oscar. This is a version, a puro tango instrumental by by Sexteto Mayor.
Thank you. Agustín Bardi. He was a prolific composer and he wrote more than 70 tangos and waltzes. The title of the song, Gallo Ciego, is quite a curious one, and it has sort of a paradox in the meaning of the title, because in the Lunfardo dialect of the Porteño district of Buenos Aires, Gallo means a showy, confident kind of guy. You know, he's got the hat, he's got the suit, he's got the attitude, and he struts around as he owns the place. But here comes the paradox, because ciego means penniless, and so he might have the shiny suit, but he just hasn't got a penny in his pocket. Now, I'm going to digress here a little bit, because all of us here are here because we love tango, and some of us might even be a little bit addicted. You know, once, twice, three times a week, maybe? You know, 10 pairs of shoes in the little bags. And when you get to that stage, you usually have your own favourite piece of music and your favourite composer. And my particular favourite is